In this video, I'm going to show you how to solve a common problem when recording your microphone using QuickTime Player on the Mac. And that problem is your microphone sound only coming out of the left speaker. Hey, it's Mike with more tips and tutorials to help you create great video for your YouTube channel, your video marketing, or online courses. Thank you so much for being here. QuickTime Player on the Mac is a simple, versatile, and free media creation tool, but it has a few limitations. You'll quickly run into one of these limitations when you try to record audio using an XLR microphone like this Rode NT1A connected to a USB audio device like this Focusrite Scarlett Solo. As you can hear, my voice is only coming out of the left speaker. That's because USB interfaces like the Scarlett Solo split the incoming audio signal. Typically, the XLR or microphone input goes to channel 1, the left channel in a stereo pair, and the instrument input goes to channel 2, the right channel. So your microphone signal sits on the left channel, and that's how QuickTime Player records it. To remedy this microphone on the left side only issue, we need to switch the microphone input track from stereo, left side only, to mono, which will place your microphone sound on both the left and right channels, so it comes out of both left and right speakers. Unfortunately, you can't do that in QuickTime Player. You can't switch the microphone track input from stereo to mono, like you can in other audio software. QuickTime Player is stereo only, which is why the microphone signal from your USB interface plays only through the left speaker in the QuickTime Player recording. There's a simple solution to this problem, and that solution is GarageBand, that digital music studio that comes bundled with every Mac, at least at the time of this recording. I'm going to show you how to use GarageBand to convert our stereo or left side only QuickTime recording into a mono recording so that the microphone sound comes out of both speakers. Let's jump into it. So here we are in GarageBand. This is version 10.3.2 running on macOS Mojave 10.14.3 for your reference. When you open GarageBand, you get this Choose a Project dialog window. I'm just going to double click Empty Project. The GarageBand editing interface opens up into an empty project and it asks us to create a track. I'm just going to double click on this microphone button to create a microphone track. It doesn't really matter because we're not going to use this track. And here's the editing interface in GarageBand with the one microphone track we created. Now, before we go any further, I'm just going to go up here and click on this purple button with the metronome icon to deselect it. If it's selected, you get a clicking sound when you play your track. Great for timing music, but distracting for our purposes. So I'll just click it to deselect it. And now I'm going to bring in a recording I want to convert from stereo, left side only microphone sound, to mono, or both sides sound. I know, really scientific. To do that, you go to File, Movie, Open Movie. Yes, you can actually open videos or movies in GarageBand. The Finder opens and you can navigate to the location of your movie. Mine is on the desktop, so I'll just select it and click Open. And this big video window opens in the GarageBand interface. I'm just going to size this down so we can see what's going on. Now, this video window is a preview window, and it's connected to these two new tracks up here in the timeline. This top track is the video track of our movie. You can tell that by these frames from the video here. Below that is the audio track from our video. I'll hit the space bar to play so you can see how these are connected. So you can see the video in the preview window plays along in sync with the two tracks up here. This is a great setup for building music and sound effect tracks to create a really sophisticated soundtrack for your video. But that's another tutorial. I'm going to go back and play this video again. Now listen carefully.
You'll quickly run into one of these.
The sound from my microphone is coming out of the left speaker only, and if you recall, it's because I recorded this video in QuickTime Player using an XLR microphone connected to a USB audio interface, which was connected to my Mac. To fix this and make the microphone sound come out of both left and right speakers, I'm going to go down to this Track Settings panel, to this input setting. Now, ignore this setting on the right here. It just selects your input. What we care about is this button here with the overlapping rings icon. The overlapping rings mean stereo. If we click this button, we get a single ring, which means, you guessed it, mono, which is what we want. With this now set to mono, let's have a listen to the audio track of our video. I'll hit the space bar to play.
You'll quickly run into one of these limitations.
And now our audio is playing out of both the left and right speakers. All right, the final step in the process is to replace the old stereo left side only audio track in our video with this new mono or both sides audio track we just set. To do that, I'm going to go back up to File, Movie, and you'll see we have a new choice, Export Audio to Movie. We select that, and we get this export dialog, and you'll see it says location and name of new movie. And that's because GarageBand is going to take our existing video that we imported and the new mono audio track we made and combine them into a new movie file. Let's quickly run through these settings. Save as. So this is the file name of the movie I imported into GarageBand. Now, if I leave this as is, GarageBand will replace my old video file with the new video file it generates. Now, I don't recommend you do that. I recommend creating a new file instead, just in case something goes wrong and you need to go back to the old video file. So I'll just add underscore mono to create a new file. You can put in whatever you want there. For where, or the location where you want to export the new file to, I'll just leave it set to the desktop. And finally, we have preset. Now remember, GarageBand is creating a new video file for us. So if I leave this preset at SD, which stands for standard definition, 480p, GarageBand will generate an SD 480p video file with my new mono audio track. Now that's not what I want, so I'm just gonna hit this drop down to see if there are any other choices. As you can see, we have a few. Now these export presets are fairly self-explanatory. 9 times out of 10, I'm going to choose full quality because I like to preserve as much quality as possible in my video file before I have to compress it for uploading. So I'm going to select full quality and then hit save. And GarageBand will take the new mono audio track and combine it with my original video to create a new video file. So let's see and hear how things worked out. I'll open the file exported by GarageBand. Play it.
You'll quickly run into one of these limitations when you try to record audio using an...
And there's the new video file with the microphone sound coming out of both speakers.
Audio device like this Focusrite Scarlett Solo.
Using GarageBand to convert your QuickTime Player audio from stereo to mono is fairly straightforward, but it can be a bit tedious if you have a lot of videos you need to convert. Now, there is a more streamlined conversion method, but it involves the use of an additional application, which is free, and some coding in the terminal application on your Mac. If you're interested in learning this method, let me know in the comments below. Well, that's it for this video. I hope you found value in it. And if you're looking for more tips and tutorials for creating video, then have a look at the other videos on my channel. And of course, don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell icon so you don't miss a thing. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.